Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to Shadow Tactics. Alright, this is the hardest part of the level, for sure. It's going to be the hardest part of the level. We've been very thorough so far. We've killed a lot of people that didn't necessarily have to be killed. But I don't think let's kill everybody and put the fires out afterward is going to be a good solution here. Now notice none of the fire, or none of the light in this area is provided by torches, except for the torch that the Straw Hat's carrying. So we don't have to get in here to turn anything off, and if there were any torches in this area, it would be necessary to deal with everybody. I was going to say incapacitate, but honestly, the civilians would die. It's the only way. But really all we have to do is draw the Straw Hats off. The Straw Hats, unfortunately, are pretty close to immune to being drawn off. However, this part over here, they come over here, and I think we might be able to get them there. Is this Straw Hat? Yeah, he doesn't always look over here. We might be able to pull something off. Like a well-timed... No, a rock's not gonna work. Turn all these people away? Well, I think no matter what, the first part of the thing we're doing is we're killing this guard. So, Yuki is going to have to trap him. That's probably pretty uncontroversial. We'll just pull him behind the chicken coop. Should be easy. Sorry, easy. Should be doable. I expect this to be literally possible. No, that's not actually going to be quite as easy as all that. So, I mean, actually, I don't have to do a lot of running here, right? The nighttime makes things easier. So what I'm going to do is wait for these guys to come around. Now, I'm talking about trying to do this in some sort of stealthy, totally in control, nobody ever knows we were here kind of way. But the fact is, it's just the one guy with the torch. And, I mean, we could do some good old-fashioned create a lot of chaos, drop this dude, snuff his torch, and just run away thing. And I don't think that anybody would relight the dead guy's torch afterward. It seems absurd on its face. So this might actually be a strategy. It might come down to that. We'll see. Okay, I don't have to do any running at all, actually. Not yet. This should be pretty easy, I assume. Just like... Alright, I don't think anybody's going to be able to see him over here. And as soon as she grabs him, his body is considered to be down. Pull that. I wasn't really thinking about this dude. Oh, we're going to have to go down here and deal with... There's a ton of torch-bearing guards. If we are going to do a chaotic, sort of smash-and-grab style maneuver here, it probably makes sense to take care of the guards down by the riverside first. But let's see if there's a way to do this that's actually sneaky. Now, I can't draw them off. Which means we don't really have a lot of tools. There's nowhere that we can extinguish a fire to make them come over and want to relight the torch, and they're not going to be vulnerable to the whistle. But if we can find a spot where they're not terribly visible to other people, we could lay down a trap and have Hayato nearby or something, and just try to simultaneously kill the patrol. I think we're going to have a really hard time finding a spot where that's feasible, though. Ooh. I just told Hayato to do something that I should not. Yep. Okay. So if we were going to do something like that, well, we set a trap over here somewhere. The chickens are an issue. It would be very difficult for us to sneak up on a Straw Hat with all these chickens. So where exactly do these guys walk to? Again, we don't have to get away with this cleanly, we just have to not die. So they patrol over to here. This is not going to work. Yeah, he'd be able to see them. This is definitely the hardest one so far. Alright, well, why don't we try taking care of the guys down at the riverside first, I guess? A lot of that can be done with, Yuki. Because Whistle and Trap is a very powerful strategy. So I'm assuming neither one of these guards sees very much in this direction. Yeah, okay. So we have to watch for this guy. And there's a patrol that's really far away right now. We have to place the whistle pretty carefully to get one but not both. Alright, come on. Come on. Easy enough. We should be able to pull that maneuver off a couple more times. That's right, we have a big pile of corpses in the corner over there. We actually don't even need to do that maneuver on this guy. We can just wait for that dude to turn his back. It's a lot faster. And then, the same is true over here. We don't have to do a fancy thing. As long as this guy comes back before the patrol gets very far back. Now, for dealing with the patrol, I think we're probably going to have to do something like what we did with the last patrol of three, where we shadow mode. And everybody takes one. Which is fine. It's not going to be terribly difficult. We actually could use this as a distraction, maybe. Turn this out. I'll hide in this bush. Well, no, because they're going to walk down and around. It's going to cause them to turn around. We don't want them to do that while we're sneaking up on them. But I'll hide in this bush, I think, is pretty solid. I suppose Yuki could technically kill all three of them by herself if we did like a trap and a pistol shot and then just sprinting to the other guy. Wait, where's she jumping off of? Apparently the spot she jumped from was very slightly higher elevation. So she got her instant jump kill there. That's pretty handy. Alright. Is there any way I could reduce the number of vision cones I have to deal with here? Actually, these guys are close enough together. I wonder if I could do a sneezing powder thing. I think she should be okay. Yeah. The dark is very powerful. Could I sneezing powder and hit all three of these guys? No. But this guy's vision cone isn't really a problem normally, is it? No, it totally is. And there's still this guy to worry about, and yeah. This is going to be a real pain in the ass, actually. Alright, well, let's clear out the dudes at the riverside. What? She's still visible while jumping, is what I figured she'll get to the end of the roof and immediately become invisible, but no, that is not in fact how it works. I kind of can't believe some of the stuff we get away with. Alright, and then once the patrollers pass, it's a pretty simple walk. Yeah, this is definitely going to be the hardest part. We can kill the Straw Hat and put out the torch, like, trivially, right? When he comes down here, throw a shuriken at him. I think that that's going to be the plan. I want to take out the patrol by the river before we do that. We all just wait in these bushes. Okay. We should try to be as close together as possible, I think. And sort of roughly in the right formation. This worked out pretty well last time. We'll see how it goes this time. Obviously, this guy needs to not be watching them. We did take a little bit of damage last time. Let's go. I'm definitely nervous. Okay. Solid. Having the person who is the most injured be the one who's going to hit their target last is maybe not the greatest stroke of genius ever, but it does at least mean that I feel very justified in using her bandage. It's quite efficient now. Alright. Two more torches. These ones... how dangerous are these going to be? How many people can see this guy right now? Looks like he's the only one who sees him. Uh-oh. Call it off. Alright, his vision should be quite poor in the dark. Totally safe to go to here. And then we can extinguish this torch, if we're careful about the timing, to draw this guy down the stairs. Or... nope, doesn't care. Okay. Couple more torches over here. Well, I can probably whistle this guy down. Yeah. Okay. Grabbed him just to shorten the animation, get him down as fast as possible. Alright, so it looks like the torches left to clear are right here. The one carried by this guy. And then all of them are up on this last ledge area. We're getting pretty close. How are we doing on our goals? I don't even remember what all the badges were. Don't use this guy's don't enter the water. Extinguish all torches. Those are what we're going for right now. And then this thing can be... can be next time. We know the level really well at this point. So how are we gonna... Let's try out the murder him with a shuriken and then hide plan. Now his His torch won't actually go out until we run over there and touch it. We've spawned two more torches. It's not looking great. Let's see when the Fuhrer dies down a little bit. Let's see where these two guys go with their torches. These three guys, all three of them have torches. Because if they fan out all over the village, then that's just made things harder, and we'll try to come up with a better way of dealing with the Straw Hats. If they go into, say, a patrol formation together or something, some way that we could deal with them, potentially, then we'll just do that. Alright, so let's see what we got. One goes to here, which is a very killable position. One goes over here, which is a very killable position. Where'd that third dude go? There were three of them, right? I need my shuriken. This might not be doable. Okay. That guy sort of saw me around the corner due to the torchlight, which is a little odd. Alright, we probably want Yuki to deal with this guy. So yeah, this is totally doable. I don't think this is gonna be a problem. Alright, Yuki is in this bush over here. Theoretically, it should be possible to get this guy, like, in a whole bunch of places. It did spawn three red guards, didn't it? I thought I saw three initially. Maybe I was mistaken. Alright. Yeah, maybe it was just two. I don't see a third torch. Oh, he went over here. Well, that's an annoying place for him to have gone. Now I gotta backtrack. Still, I think that this was maybe the only way I was gonna get this guy. I don't really know what else I could have done. Alright, so just like last time, pretty easy. His torch is not actually out. I think. Yeah, okay, there we go. Yeah, he was providing light that whole time. That's why it was so hard to get to the shuriken. Okay, this should be as easy as throwing the shuriken at this guy from the roof, I think. Damn it. It is as simple as throwing the shuriken from the roof. As long as, you know, I'm paying attention to the patrols. I didn't do that right at all. Can I throw a rock far enough for it to matter? I don't know how it was so easy the first time, but I just completely can't do it now. I cannot. Sorta. There we go. Easy. Totally reasonable. That is a sleeping live guard right there. Can I walk around this side? Okay, this will be a little bit better. So, I mean, I don't have to throw the shuriken, right? It might be faster just to stab him, but we want to make sure that this guard is not looking when it happens. And when we stab him, the torch he's holding goes out instantly. Well, shit. I guess if I throw the shuriken at him and then run over and touch him right away, does it put the torch out right away, or do I have to wait for him to finish falling? It might be that I have to wait for him to finish falling. This is totally doable, just running over and stabbing him. I just have to actually be watching his vision cone. Instead of just assuming I'm in the clear. There you go. Alright, easy. So there's no torches. There is one torch. Which is actually going to necessitate this guy's... Ooh, probably the samurai too. Because enemies that see the torch will relight it. Alright, let's see if I can take this guy down. If I can't, then I maybe have to do this a little bit differently. Although, I might just have time... Oh, I have time? Alright. Okay. When the samurai and this guy are talking, nobody's looking at this guard. So this is doable, but it is going to be a little bit... fiddly, I think. Also, I need to quick save more often, more frequently. Right. Yeah, because if the samurai is still up, then he'll relight the torch. But we can... No, we cannot. I was going to say we can use the torch to draw him away. But he'll just... He won't quite go out of this guy's vision range. So it seems like I do have to draw this guard off with Yuki. And kill him anyway. So we may as not... May as well not, go for the super difficult version of this thing. Let's just... Have Yuki come up here, draw this guy off into the shadows and deal with him. And then the two of us can work together to take down the samurai, which will be a little bit easier than having Hayato do the whole thing. Looks like we broke the patrol path of the Straw Hat, which is kind of nice. And the way he's standing, we can pretty safely just walk into the bush without even really caring about his vision cone. Yeah, even when it's over here, it doesn't see us. Okay, so where can we... Where can we whistle and pull this guard away? It looks like I actually can't get him around the corner. Why don't we try dropping this here? And then whistling... as close as we have to grab him. Out of curiosity, if we whistle while he's having his conversation with the samurai, but we don't get in samurai range, will the samurai follow him? This is just science. I'm just doing science here. The answer is yes. So that's not great. If this guy wasn't facing us... Okay, so when they're conversing, they act like a patrol unit. That's very, very good information. The samurai turned around and looked at him right before I was going to stab him. He actually may have saved my life there. Because I was going to have her jump out of the bush right as this patrolling guy was coming back. Okay, so we do want to wait until the samurai leaves. I'm sure the fact that conversing guards behave like a linked patrol is going to be useful at some point. Alright, I really need you to not be over here. Why is it so hard to get this guy alone? Okay. It was crazy difficult. Alright, crazy difficult. I mean, I had to wait a very small amount of time. So difficult's maybe not the right word, but, okay. But, you know, I got slightly bored during it, so that's almost the same thing. Alright. Alright, you guys. Does the samurai walk away first? Because if he does, the guy's dead. Okay. He does not. Well, we could do a whistle thing with this guard, but I'm pretty sure the way his patrol works, we should get a clean shot at him at some point over here. Because I think he walks all the way out of this guy's vision range, and the samurai turns to his right before coming back over here. So, also, he gets distracted by the fact that his buddy is missing. If he walks back here, we can use Yuki's final matchlock shot to set up a kill for Hayato to come in on. It looks like he's not going to. Oh, maybe. Well, I'm certainly ready. He is steadfastly refusing to go anywhere useful. Well, at this point, I think the plan is turn off the light. Make the samurai come to it. Oh, damn it. Yep. Totally within that guy's cone. So if that guy can see all the way to the light, hold on a second. No, he can't. Oh, he can sometimes. He, like, changes his angle a little bit, it looks like, when he's drinking. Yeah, that's so weird. When he drinks, his whole body shifts to the side? How does that work? Well, that's pretty weird. So what's actually safe, then? I'm pretty sure that means the samurai's patrol path never leaves visual range of the city. This little village, rather. He's vulnerable over here sometimes, but not all the time. Okay, as soon as that guy stops drinking, I'm going for it. I'm sneaking right now, sir. Yeah, his vision cone being lined doesn't actually seem to matter. So then I want two people over here, because we have to shoot him from one side and attack him from the other. It's pretty weird that he sees you instantly, even if you're sneaking in the lined part of his cone. I maybe did this too quickly. She might get spotted. Depending on what he does here. Okay, no, what he does here is give up, because he's a big coward. Alright, so I need two people over here. Hayato goes to here, where he's perfectly safe. It seems like. I'll maybe even go to here. Just like way down. Seems like we're safe here. So then when the samurai comes back, Hayato can shoot him without alerting anybody, except maybe this civilian that keeps running back and forth over here. I didn't see whether that guy was friendly or not. Okay. I think we're safe where I am. Yeah, just barely. Alright, then we have to watch this guy's vision. As soon as he turns, we get everybody's attention as soon as we fire the shot. Am I going to have to clear out the village substantially for this to work? Yeah, because like this guy can see, he can't see where the torch is. And this guy can, is it the case that this guy only sees where the torch is when he's drinking? Because I guess we're going to have to do the torch thing, but we're just going to have to pray that the samurai noticing the torch lines up with this guy not looking at him. No, he can see the torch even with his normal vision. But he can't exactly see. He can't see the area just north of the torch, like a step or two off of it. Maybe that's got to be the plan? We have to catch the samurai going to the torch, but not actually on the torch, and only when this guy isn't looking to his left, or looking to his right, to drink, which is ridiculous because you do not have to look to your right to drink. That's not how the human body works. I'm going to drink some water right now. Check this out. Okay, that probably wasn't very conclusive for you guys, but listen, you're going to have to trust me. I did not turn my head to the right. What is this? Samurai's breaking pattern. He walked over here and then immediately back here instead of doing the part where he walks over to this spot. It's weird. Okay, so yeah, it looks like what I have to do is turn this off, put this out. That guy notices it and comes over. That's actually maybe better. Because if we can get him without the samurai, then, come on, get out of the cone, damn it. I need to pull him back to here. Yeah, if we do get the drinker's attention without the samurai and we kill him, that makes killing the samurai a lot more easy. A lot easier, you know, whatever, man, listen. There's a lot of ways in the English language to express the same idea, or at least similar ideas, depending on your desired degree of precision. Alright. So that guy will notice eventually. Yeah, when he starts drinking, he notices. Then he'll come over here. Where's the samurai at this point? He's at the campfire. Whoa! Did you see that? The samurai saw him instantly. He touched the vision cone and immediately was seen. That is not how the vision cones in this game usually work. Is the samurai in... I guess he's in high alert mode still from the... Do they stay in high alert mode forever? Once they've been alerted? No, his cone's decreasing. Huh. Yeah, okay, it goes back to normal. This is weird. Weird stuff is happening here. Alright. So this guy comes over here. The samurai's about to turn around. Yeah. If he notices that the torch is unlit, his vision cone goes all the way to yellow. Alright, so we have to get a lucky cycle here, basically. We have to get the guard to notice the torch while the samurai is walking away, basically. Yeah, and the samurai moves in a completely... not completely. Samurai moves, it seems like, in a semi-random way between the three points that he's supposed to go to. Damn it, do you have to do that right now? Couldn't you wait just a second? Alright. This is definitely not going to work. Right, because now the samurai is going to turn back around. Maybe he can walk over here. Be a pal. Just walk over here. See if your friend's back yet. Maybe he got back. He's just going to the bathroom. I very nearly got caught there. Alright. I'm starting to think that maybe I need to set up a trap. Maybe I should have Yuki wait down here. Let's try that. So I'm going to put this out. I have a Yuki wait down here. He just doesn't care. Maybe if I wait until after he fixes the torch? Because until the torch is on, he's on a mission, right? Dude is absolutely focused. Single-minded dedication. That you only really get from random drunk dudes during the Edo period. They love duty. Okay, but now he's fulfilled his duty. Maybe now he can be distracted by birds. Yes. Okay, so the samurai can't see this. All right. That was like a lot more work than it needed to be. It's possible I made that unnecessarily difficult. Okay, so now everybody actually cannot see the torch. Okay. Now the torch is clear. So now we need to sneak Yuki back up. Yeah, this'll do. I don't know why I didn't have her snuff the torch on her way past. That seems like a sensible way to approach it. Okay. So it's going to be Hayato's pistol, just so that we have ammo in Yuki's in case, you know, should the case arise that we have to do a three-gun salute thing to finish the level off or something. And Yuki can get the kill. This should be pretty easy, but has not been so far. Actually, I don't like this plan at all. I mean, I like the plan, but I think we should swap their spots. Because he's going to immediately see Hayato if we do it this way. The gunshot needs to come from the further bush. Everything else about the plan is great, it just needs to not be the close bush that does it. Okay, finally, and now that torch should stay doused. I guess, actually, I always had to kill this guy because he would have relit the torch. Okay. So there's a couple of wandering civilians over here. Let's verify that they don't relight it real quick, but I think neither of them sees it. I don't know where the dude over here runs off to. He comes down to the house and then runs off the map and then... Alright. This woman... Oh, is a friendly. She probably wouldn't relight torches anyway. Yep, and here's this guy. Can't select him. Here we go. He does not see the torch. Okay. And he is not friendly. He would totally tell on us. Alright, so there's a number of guards over here. Most of whom are not Straw Hats. So Yuki ought to be able to do quite a bit of work. Killing this guy should be pretty easy, as long as this Straw Hat's not right here. Alright, and as usual, as soon as he hits that trap... Oh, it's a pair of Straw Hats rotating around, I think. I assumed it was just one guy walking around the lip of the building, but it's... Yeah, it's a pair of them completely opposite, so there won't be a window. Unless we can kill them. And it kind of looks like there's no way up here. Yeah, we can't use this thing. We can use gunshots. It's not totally ideal. Alright. One from Hayato, one from Yuki, two from Aiko. And how many torches do we have left? One, two... We can't unlight the braziers. This guy... No, this guy does not have a torch. He's just lit by this. We do have to kill one more samurai. So we need a bullet for that. It shouldn't be a problem, though. It shouldn't be a problem to shoot these guys, as long as I can do it in a place where they won't be immediately seen. And I have to remember that the second one has to be shot before he reports the death of the first one. So I think I'm actually going to have maybe Aiko do both of the shots, or... Yeah, somebody's going to be out of ammunition when we're done with this. Kind of curious if we can... Nope, people totally see that. So maybe we can't do this? Or like we have to kill them on this side and these guards have to be dead first? Then this guy can see everything that guy can't, yeah. Alright, so yeah, at least a couple of these guards have to be dead before we can do this. Alright, well, let's try drawing people off in this direction. Is there any chance I can... No, I cannot even come close to grabbing these guys... to pulling these guys behind the buildings with the whistle. Oh, you can't actually see him. The samurai is a patroller. Oh my god, the guard density is so high. What's my actual mission objective? Okay, we have to listen in on Okoto, so that's good because it's hard to do accidentally. We definitely don't want to end this prematurely. This is going to be tough. These guys are going to be tough. This would be easier to do if we could use Aiko's disguise, because she could go through the building, I think. We can't do it on the last level, but I'm thinking that that's a special case kind of thing. Okay, well, what if I could just pull this guy... Oh. Okay. I don't have to pull this guy all that far for him to be out of this guard's range. And in the dark, I might be able to grab the body and go back into sneak mode before the Straw Hats alarm on him? Maybe? I don't know. I don't feel confident about that, obviously. I have to wait pretty close to the edge of his vision. Okay. That actually worked. And nobody will miss him. So I can start putting out the lights, and the Straw Hats will notice, but won't go to do anything about it, because that's like their whole deal. What about this light? Is this visible to anybody but this Straw Hat? I don't know if the samurai sees it at the end of his path or not. Yeah, he sees it, but, like, what? What? Do something. Come on. Okay, this guard, the guard himself notices the light go out. I guess that makes an awful lot of sense. Yes, go investigate that. That's very interesting to you. Oh, come on. Straw Hat? This Straw Hat is the worst. Come on, just pull him back, pull him back. Okay. I thought for a second this guy was going to hesitate on seeing this torch so long that I wasn't going to get an opportunity. But he turned away just in time. Alright, so just drop this guy by the other guys. And then I think we can just shut off both of these lights. This one's a little risky. But if this light is off, it gives me a much better approach. Okay. They all notice and do nothing and care not. It is worth noting that this is upsetting the guards a lot. It's making their vision cones very yellow. Yeah, and he's too short to see it. Okay. So... now, this wall, this part of the thing is unwatched. And we maybe could pull off a kill here. How close to the building? Okay, what if I might be able to whistle this guard right next to the building without having the, I'm gonna have to move pretty quickly, though. Okay, I think he should die in a place where nobody sees him. The guard heard that, but he doesn't know what it was, and he can't check. Uh-oh. I may have broken... okay, I screwed up the routing. We may as well shove this dude in this building, why not? Yeah, they're behaving really weird now. Very strangely. Okay, it looks like they want to be synced up. And so they wait. If they get desynced, they wait and resync. I probably don't have to move these bodies into the building, but it's a place where they're absolutely for sure safe, as opposed to on the ground over here where they're only very probably safe. Yuki, do it quickly. Quickly, Yuki. Okay, just in time. Alright. So now we need to draw off one more torchbearer over here, and then a straw hat and a samurai over here, and we have to clear that torch as well. But that's not going to be that difficult, I imagine. So I'm wondering if maybe the play with this guy is to draw him into the bush. I mean, it's going to be so hard to get this guard to not notice him dying, but I guess maybe we can have Hayato, where are you at? I mean, if Hayato sneak up, and when the guard's about to step on the trap, we can throw a rock? Right, like, what if I get up here, how far can I throw a rock from a position of safety? Yeah, this would work. Alright, let's try it. Sometimes Okoto can see over here as well. This is maybe not a real plan. Although I guess if I put the trap over here, then do the call. Did I not get him? I didn't get him. There we go. Okay. Now he may not step on it at all. Come on, step forward, step forward. Alright, when she grabs him, it puts him into downed mode immediately. That totally worked. Awesome. Okay, and then we can probably do something fairly similar. Let's wait for Okoto to turn again so that I can see exactly where his vision cone is and is not. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to whistle this dude at the edge and just hope he walks into the bush far enough to step on the trap. It's not a terrible plan. It'll probably work. And this time it's even easier. We don't have to do any crazy timing stuff. Of course, there's no guarantee he actually steps on the trap either. Ah, they just can't help themselves. Okay, that leaves three torches. Straw hat and samurai and this thing. And we haven't had to kill these guys yet, but I think we'll have to now. So where's Aiko? Yeah, I'm gonna kill one right here, so that we can kill the other one on this side without him noticing. And the reason I want to do this is just that we have the maximum possible clearance to deal with these guards, however we want to deal with them. I cannot believe how quiet these guns are. Alright. So now we could just do a synchronized shadow mode thing. That's probably safe. We could do synchronized gunfire from Yuki plus shuriken from Hayato, and that will leave us with one shot left on Hayato to drop the samurai, which should be pretty straightforward if both of these straw hats are dead. Actually, hold on. That's the one we're getting close to, so I'm going to have Aiko do that. It can be Aiko stabs a guy, and simultaneously, Hayato throws a shuriken. Okay. I'm not going to put these commands both in. I'm going to hit enter, and then I'm going to do this like that. Okay, easy. I mean, yeah, when he goes to relight this, that'll be the time. So we have her wait over here. Hayato shoots him, and then Aiko takes him down. I think it should work. Alright. That's, I think, all of the torches, although I notice we have not been given a badge yet. Maybe this is one of the ones that triggers at the end, but also maybe I missed something. Right, it does just say torches, right? All torches, including torches carried by enemies. Well, it sure looks like I've done it to me. This guy doesn't have a torch, right? Yeah, you can see both of his hands. None of these guys have a torch. I might have missed a torch just planted in the ground somewhere. That's possible. Let's do a quick recap of the area. So we came through here. Nobody in the village has a torch, right? Nobody that I've left alive. That doesn't look like it. I mean, we could clear the village if we have to, if this isn't working. I'm not able to interact with the... Actually, let's turn on the interaction highlights. I'm not able to interact with the fire. Can't extinguish that. Can't extinguish any of these braziers. It's interesting that this torch is still... highlighted. Oh, that's a lit torch right there. Let's make sure it's the only one before I go making any plans. Yeah, okay, looks like. I can't believe I did that. Alright, should be trivial to go back and get it though, right? Since basically everybody's dead. Alright, sorry about that, guys. It's not perfectly ideal for me to have to go back and do this. On the plus side, it is not going to be very dangerous. Still no badge. Did I really miss one? None of these guys have torches, right? No, we can see all their hands. It has taken a little bit for some of them to register. Maybe this is just that, or maybe I have to complete the level. That's a brazier. That's a brazier. Yeah, I don't see any light sources that are coming from torches. Yeah, maybe it's one of these ones where you gotta finish the level? Let's try it. Alright, so this should be pretty easy. It's just a matter of getting into this bush over here. Bam. Alright, so the last quick save is right after we snuffed that other torch. Hopefully, this is one that's awarded on level completion. It checks to see if they're extinguished. Okay. This didn't spawn any new lights or anything. Okay. Okay, gather near the rafts. Yeah, it looks... I don't know, it looks done. Let's find out. I have to walk out today. Honestly, there's no reason for me to walk out in that direction anyway, right? There's a perfectly safe path right here. Run, Nyko, run! It doesn't... Hold on. I wonder if it means I have to actually go set off these alarms so that I can kill these red guys? Because, like, I wouldn't think so. I wouldn't think that they exist from the game's perspective if they haven't been spawned. But I can't see what else would be preventing me from getting this. The AI is not very good about using your ninja powers. Alright, where is... Here she is, okay. She gets lost in the item highlights because she's the same color as... Aiko! She won't jump off of a 3-foot-tall ledge without my express written instructions. But she has no problem leaping in a lake. What are you doing? Jump down. She's got no sense of propriety, this one. Just breaking my heart. Okay, apparently everybody needs to be ordered to go to here. And then I will walk you down the dock carefully myself. Yeah, I can't imagine that it wants me to kill the red guys that have torches. I can try spawning all of them and killing them, but that doesn't seem right to me. Alright, let's see if we got it. Yes, okay, it's awarded on completion. Okay. So, we're going to have to do one more run of this level, not killing anyone and not raising any alarm, but I think that's going to be a whole video unto itself. So, thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you're enjoying the series as much as I'm enjoying making it. If you are, please leave comments and likes below. You know, it helps me out greatly when you guys do that stuff. Come back next time. I know, listen, I'm as tired of Hida Village as you are, but we're going to run it one last time, perfect ghost mode, somehow. It's going to help a lot that we can use the disguise now. And we'll see you then.